प्रीवियस ईयर नीट क्वेश्चंस इन न्यूक्लियर फिजिक्स चैप्टर वी आर डिस्कसिंग बेटा यार। सो सपोज इफ यू ऑब्जर्व 2017 इन 2017 नीट व्हाट वी गॉट हियर मींस दे टोल्ड रेडियो एक्टिव मटेरियल ये दे हैव टेकन रेडियो एक्टिव मटेरियल ये it has a decay constant they have given it as 8 lambda and material b they have taken and this is the first material a and second material they have taken b and here the decay constant simply they have given it as lambda now they told that initially they have same number of nuclei that is initial nuclei of the material a and material b both are same so both are equal to let us write n naught initial nuclei means n naught both are same in a and b substances so now our target is here they are asking that after what time ratio of number of nuclei material b to that of a will be 1 by a that means after what time Na by Nb value, that means remaining nuclei in A and remaining nuclei in B ratio will be equal to 1 by E. This sum even it came in previous year, other competitive exams so many times beta, not only NEET, so many other competitive exams also, we find this model sum. Not exactly same values, but different values we got in other competitive exams also. So in engineering entrance exams as well as in medical entrance exams, so many different entrance exams this type of model. But only the thing is, your values are different. Values are different. Remaining question is same. So this is the given, and they are asking to find what is the time taken to happen this one. Time taken to happen the ratio of remaining nuclei that is Na by Nb is 1:1:E. 1:1:E or Na by Nb equal to 1 by E. Here initial number of nuclei N0, N0, we both are same. And first this is one substance, these are two substances here. A and B are two substances. A has decay constant 8 lambda. B has decay constant lambda. Let us observe this one beta. I hope you are clear with the question now. Now, actually what we know is n is equal to n naught into e power minus lambda t is our formula. So in this formula, if you write here, n naught is same. In the both the things, n naught is same. So n naught is same means n is proportional to e power minus lambda t. So n1 by n2 is equal to e power, first substance is having lambda 1. Second substance is having decay constant as lambda 2. At the same time instant, they are asking us to find. So lambda 1, they have given it as what beta? 8 lambda. And lambda 2, they have given it as lambda. In previous page, I found those things. Now, they also have given one for, we got this information from the relation of n is proportional to e power minus lambda t. And they have given n1 by n2 is equal to 1 by e. So now comparing these two informations, I can write e power minus lambda 1 t by e power minus lambda 2 t is equal to 1 by e. Or I can also write it as 1 by e power lambda minus lambda 1 minus lambda 2 into t is equal to 1 by e. Carefully observe beta here. Minus lambda 1 t, e power minus lambda 1 t numerator, I brought to the denominator. Here minus is there, so it became plus. So a minus becomes plus when it comes to the denominator. Power minus will comes to plus when it comes to the denominator. So I got it as now, I took the common in these two cases, I can observe. T is same. So I took the T common here and I got lambda 1 minus lambda 2. So now clearly you can observe in the base here and denominator here and denominator numerator 1 and 1. That means denominator terms are same. So from that information, I'm taking the next page. lambda 1 e power lambda 1 minus lambda 2 into t is equal to, we are having simply e. If e is there, I can put it as even e power 1 also. So from this information, what I can write here, here also e, both are e, means e, e, we have powers are same. So lambda 1 minus lambda 2 into t is equal to, I can write as 1. So lambda t is equal to, now what's the value of t means simply 1 by lambda 1 minus lambda 2. This is my formula. And in the exam, they can change the lambda 1 and lambda 2 values better. Here they have given lambda 1 value as 8 lambda and lambda 2 value as lambda. So now from the data I can write finally my answer is 1 by 7 lambda. 1 by 7 lambda. Like that we have to handle this problem better. I hope you are clear how we discussed this one. Now let us go for the next question. So here again now we are going to discuss 2016 problem. 2016 need problem beta. So in this question they told that in this 2016 need question paper, they have given that the half life is 30 minutes. Directly they told half life is 30 minutes. Half life value. I am writing capital T as half life. So yes, formula will be same. The capital T is here 30 minutes. Now the time taken between the question is, carefully watch better how to handle this one. Time taken between 40% decay, 40% decay and 85% decay, 85% decay of the same radioactive substance, of same radioactive substance, same radioactive substance. Like that they are asking the question beta here. Fine, this question is clear. So what is that one, what is the time taken they are asking, is they are asking like this, is now the half life is given for to reduce from 40% to 85%, what is the decay value, that means how much time it takes to decay from where to where beta, 40% to 40% to 85%. That is the question they ask now. Let us discuss now this one clearly here. So first of all, the simple way I can do that. So given, we are given that decay. Let us observe carefully. Decay from where to where beta? Decay is from 40% to 85%. This is the given. Fine. Therefore, how much is remaining? 40% decay means we can write. Remaining value, how much is remaining means I can write 40% decayed means we can write 60% is remaining. And here 85% decayed means I can write here 15% is remaining. So remaining values are 60% and here after 85% decay, how much is remaining? 15%. Because remaining is nothing but, remaining always we say, remaining is nothing but total minus decay, total minus decay. So total if you take it as 100, 100 minus 40, 60, like that we can do. You know very well about this one, nothing to discuss. You know decay means how much remaining you can calculate. Now, what we know is, simple way of solving the problem is 100% to 100% to 50%, it takes one half life. And 50% to 25%, it takes another half life, another half life. Like that we are telling here. Now, similarly here, this is the method we know. 100 to decay, 50% is called as half life. 50 to 25 is called as half life. This is very well known to us. Similarly, 60%, initially 60%. 60% to become half. Half means 30%. That is also called as half life. 30% to become 50%. Again, half of the 30% is 15%. This is also called as half life. Now, as this is also, we are calling it as half life here. So, how many half lives it has taken from, concentrate on our target is actually See here, our target is remaining 60% to 15%. So how many half-lives it is taking to happen this one? So how many half-lives means here? We can observe what is the half-life value they have given beta. First of all, half-life value, they mentioned it as T equal to, you can observe, T equal to 30 minutes. Now, how many half-lives we find here? Here, one. This is a one half-life. In one half-life, it became 60% to 30%. In next half-life, 30% to 15% remaining. So, total number of half-lives is equal to, small t is equal to, I can write, 2 into capital T. 2 into capital T means, capital T value they have given, 30 minutes. So 2 into 30 is nothing but 60 minutes is the answer. This is the question what we observed in the year 2016 previous year NEET question beta. I hope it is clear. So like that we are getting the questions beta. And in 2000, again if you observe 2015, let us observe what is the question is there in 2015. If you observe 2015 previous year NEET, there what happened means they have given one aluminium and small t is instantaneous time, capital T is half life. In my previous problem beta, some student got doubt what is time is capital T is half life and small t is instantaneous time. At that instant what the time is small t. Now coming to this problem, aluminium 1327, and they have taken one aluminium and another one is they have taken it as TE. So for these two elements here atomic number 53 and mass number 125, they have taken two elements, one is Al, other one is TE. Here they have given atomic number and mass number, they have given to us. And they are asking us to find the value of radius here. So we know one formula for radius. What is the radius formula beta? R is equal to R naught into a power 1 by 3. So we know that R is equal to R naught into a power 1 by 3. R naught is same. R naught is constant. This is the formula for radius and mass number, radius of nucleus. So remember, whenever they mention radius of nucleus, we can write like that, R equal to R naught into a power 1 by 3. R is constant. As R is constant, I can write now, R is proportional to a power 1 by 3. So now, what is the radius of TE they are asking? So now I can write RTE by RAL. The two elements I am writing like that. Here A1 by A2 whole power 1 by 3. So what is A1 value? A1 value is nothing but 27. What is A2 value? 125. Whole power 1 by 3. Whole power 1 by 3 means 27 can be written as 3 cube. And this one can be written as 5 cube. Whole power 1 by 3. Whole power 1 by 3 means simply I can write 3:5. So the relation between these two radius is RTE is equal to 3 by 5 of R aluminium, radius of aluminium. Like that we can get the relation here. I hope you understood this some beta. How to handle the condition when they have given in this model, how to handle this sum. So, like these sums are given in previous years, last 2017 sum, 2016 and 2015 sums, if you observe, they are in these models. In previous years, NEET, not only in previous years, NEET, this type of sums we are finding in all other competitive exams also beta.